crisis. If you don't know already, Boris Johnson has put the country, the UK, I mean, well, not the UK, but England, into a second lockdown, which means, it's not as strict as the first lockdown, but just read about the first lockdown and compare it to the second lockdown. Like, this is just an example, but with lockdown you can only travel for like work and to get shops and stuff. You can't go like, you can't think, oh, I fancy taking a trip out to, I don't know, the zoo or anything, because all non-essential shops have been forced to close. So anything that's not like essential to our economy, you know, has been forced to shut. You can't do anything, so only the main stuff that you really need, you know, food, etc., is open. Like clothes shops and stuff are all shut, gyms, etc. Funnily enough though, the schools are still open, which there's like a 50-50. Half the parents want to shut the school, and half don't, you know, because basically then, you know, the lockdown won't be effective. Like, the main spread is through like schools and colleges and universities. So yeah, I think I don't believe in a second lockdown, but if we're gonna go all out and make it as effective as we can, then I do believe we need to shut the schools. So what this has meant for me personally is, if you haven't seen some of my previous videos, I live at two different locations. One house I live at pretty much all year, and the other house I live at for winter. But basically, I needed to travel home to the winter house, the house that I'm spending the winter at. But basically, lockdown is this Thursday, so basically, traveling, you know, there's like a set of rules for traveling, where you can and can't travel for, and traveling just, you know, for the sake of it, doesn't count for the rules. So yeah, I've had to come home at least a few weeks earlier. So literally, he announced it on, I think it was Sunday or something. No, he announced it on Friday. The lockdown was announced, and then literally, I've had to come home within a few days, you know, within a couple of days, packed up. We had to pack up the car, you know, get it rammed full of stuff, and then there's like a really, really long car journey. So I did that journey today. It's so long. It was like 6 hours or something. It was so long, and we got lost. I know, like, because it's such a long journey, we only have to do it a couple of times a year. But and then there was traffic as well. There'd been a huge accident with like three cars being, you know, really properly smashed up. So yeah, that held us up for 20 minutes. Then we got lost, which added on like an extra 45 minutes. And yeah, luckily we managed to get to a place where we'd been before. Like, so where I live, there's a place up the road, you know, about 40 minutes up the road, something like that. We managed to get there, and obviously, having a bit of experience in that area, we managed to just go home the way we knew, because I have got sat nav, you know, I've got Google Maps, but it's not really, you know, sometimes it's not really reliable. Like, it sends you, you know, different ways, and you know, it doesn't reroute your route very well. Like, it had to reroute the route three times, yeah, or something. But then every time it was trying to send us all the way back that way, the way we came. So we just kept travelling down this one certain route. Eventually my map synced up with the actual way we were going, because we managed to find the sign for where we needed to be. And thank God we got where we needed to be. So we've just got, we got home, and then had to unpack the car, and then have us dinner, and then yeah, it's been a really, really long day, guys. I'm staying in a single.